jump schooling storm at Moorland, which will be really fun. I'm really excited and I'm hoping to leave in about an hour or so. Let's go get him ready. Decided to use my more fancy halter today. It was a bit dirty, so I did have to give him a wash. I put on his travel boots. And now it was time to get him out to his trailer. Then I said bye to Storm and headed off the trailer and I closed up a ramp. See you guys when I get there. Storm and I have now arrived at Moorland and he settled into a stable. I'm gonna tack him up soon and then we'll get out and do some show jumping. And I popped on his jumping saddle pad. And yes, I thought we'd go fancy and use his nice white one. And I popped on my helmet and I swapped his halter for his bridle. And I'm using his nice black bridle today. And I actually used a small stool to get on because he is quite a big horse. He was very forward today. He really wanted to get out there, especially since it's a new place. When I got to the arena, I just walked him on and he wanted to go into trot, but I just kept him in a nice rhythm and I did lots of circles to keep him in that rhythm and to keep him from not rushing off into trot. Here I was actually gonna do a exercise that I learnt a couple weeks ago in a lesson that I did. So you do a 10 meter circle, which wasn't the most fluent one, and then you come back to wall, and then you do another 10 meter circle a few seconds after you've gone back to wall, and then you come back to the track again. And we did that a couple of times in this session just to loosen him up and make sure that he wasn't going to rush off, because like I've said a lot already in this video, he was very forward. Storm was ready and warmed up. We did some trotting and he really stepped into a rhythm here and listened to me, which is usually what he does because he doesn't really like walk. It just gets a little bit boring. And as soon as we go into trot, his listening ears are on and he is very responsive. I actually set up a few poles to go over. I always like to do a few poles before we start jumping. Just to kind of get him into the zone of it. And he really enjoyed it. After we did it at trot on both reins, I was gonna do it at canter, but I just ended up doing a little bit more on this rein because I wanted to build up a little bit more muscle, because otherwise if I kept on going more on the other rein, then it'd become one-sided. Storm has a really forward, nice canter, which is why I like using him for eventing lots, because he loves the show jumping because it's jumping, then he likes the galloping of the country, and he just aces dressage. That's probably his strong point. Then show jumping is probably his second strong point, and he doesn't do well in cross country. Very kindly actually able to use the Bobcat's jumping supplies, so I have plenty of jumps to jump over and work Storm over. This diagonal fence, I just kept him at a slower canter because I was getting very excited with all of my big jumps. I made a little course, and so first was this diagonal upright, which he flew, obviously, because he's Storm and he struggles to knock fences, which is good and bad at the same time, because sometimes he just gets a little bit too full of himself and overexcited, and doesn't think about them. So their water beater was really good, and then I made this tight turn to this pink, which he did really nicely. And then I turned him around to this triple. I took him round the outside of the cone, and up over this was pretty big. Then this one, which I could have pushed for a bit, and that one I just knew would fly it. And then after that, of course, you go round to this one, which I nearly got a bad striding to, but we just made it work out okay. And then you come along the inside of this jump and come to this crosspole kind of vertical fence. And then you cross through those cones and you come all the way round to the last tricky jump, which is actually at a corner. Never jumped a jump like that, but he flew it and I was really happy with him. Now I didn't film us getting back because I didn't have enough time. So the course at Gallop, I rode him horrifically, but at the extent of canter, he did it really well. The sort of thing we need to work on, it was quite a small arena, but we should work on it a bit more before we do any more show jumping competitions or venting competitions, because jump-offs will take me out if I keep riding like that. Storm has had his dinner now, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!